Welcome to DWBI Adda channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Welcome back to the playlist on computer vision. In the last lecture, we discussed about some of the basic NumPy operations such as creating a 1D array in NumPy, creating a 2D array in NumPy, and the shape and size of a NumPy array. In this particular hands-on coding exercise video, we will be having a look at the NumPy reshape operations as well as some of the arithmetic operations that are available to us in NumPy. So without wasting much of our time, let's get started. So I will straight away go and fire up my Jupyter notebook. In my Jupyter notebook, I will write the code and hopefully you can get an understanding of these concepts from the coding exercise itself. So let us get started. This is the code from the last lecture actually. So I will just continue this here only. So we have been asked to we are now having a look at the NumPy reshape operations, right? So when we are having a look at the NumPy reshape operations, the first thing you should remember is what do you mean by a shape in NumPy. So shape in NumPy actually gives you the number of rows cross the number of columns that is available to us in a matrix or in a 2D NumPy array. Reshaping actually means changing the dimensions of the number of rows and columns, keeping in mind the number of elements actually remain the same. For example, if you have a 4x4 matrix, that means in total you have 16 elements. So you can reshape that to an 8x2 matrix or a 2x8 matrix as per your will, because 2x8 or 8x2 in any ways is 16. Or maybe you can reshape it to 16x1 matrix as well, because the number of elements remains the same. So reshape actually means changing the shape of the matrix in simple terms. So let us see how do we actually change the shape of the matrix. So what I will do is I will first create a 2D NumPy matrix. I hope you remember how to create one. So creating a 2D NumPy matrix, let's say I have this matrix over here. I will put in some random alphabets. You can put in some numbers of your choice as well. And then, so this is a 4x4 matrix that I currently have. So if I print c.shape, it should actually give me 4x4. Now I want to reshape this into an 8x2 matrix, that is, it should have 8 rows and 2 columns. How to do that is just using the NumPy reshape operation. So I will just write c is equals to numpy dot reshape, and I will pass in the first argument, which is the name of the matrix, which in our case is c, and then the shape to which we want it to get converted to. So I want it to get converted into 8x2 matrix. So I will just run this code over here, and now I will actually print in C over here. So you will see that C gets converted into 8x2 matrix, that is, it has 8 rows and 2 columns. So if I print C.shape, it would actually give me 8x2. So this is how we actually use a NumPy reshape operation. Now we will talk about some of the basic arithmetic operations that are available to us in NumPy. So the basic arithmetic operations that are available to us in NumPy are the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So when we are talking about a 2D NumPy matrix, it's a simple matrix addition, multiplication, subtraction and division. Also we have like some special functions like the sum functions in NumPy, like where you can sum up all the elements and stuff like that. So let's have a look at it. Let's say I have a 2D NumPy matrix, which I will declare it something like 1, 3, 5, and 7, and then 2, 4, 8, 10. So what I will do is I will have a 4x4 matrix for the sake of simplicity. So 3, 2, 1, 5, and 11, 13, 15. Okay, let's say it's 15, 17, and I do have, I will just copy this over here, and I do have another matrix like this in which I will actually change some of the values. So let's say I am changing some of the random values over here. Actually save some of my time and your time as well. So 19. Let's say we have these things. And now if I print D and then I print E as well. So you will see like how these matrix look like. So these matrix look something like this. Now I want to add these two matrices. So for adding two matrices, I will directly use f is equals to d plus e. And if I print f, this should give me the result. So let's do this. As you can see, the two matrices has been added. It's a simple matrix addition, as you can see from the example, because 13 plus 13 is 26, 15 plus 19 over here is 34 and stuff like that. So it's a basic matrix addition. Similarly, we can have something like the matrix multiplication, division and subtraction as well. So I will just show you all of these examples by E, and I will add a backslash N to it. Print that in a new line actually. Something like this and something like this. So yes, you can see like the results are as follows. Like, because they were the same numbers, it has been replaced with zero in subtraction and then multiplication and then division as well. So this is how we actually use some of the basic arithmetic operations in NumPy. Another operation that is available to us in NumPy is the sum operation. Let's say I have this array A created over here, which is my 1D array, and I want to know the sum of all the elements that are present in the array. So in the NumPy 1D array, so how would I do that? The first thing that I can do is to actually use like a for loop where I could traverse through each and every element of the array and sum up all the elements. That is how we generally do. But NumPy actually gives you this special function which is known as numpy.sum. So np.sum, and if I call in a over here, so it will return me the sum. Be sum actually. So the sum that is returned me is 9, and if I see, so 1, 3, and 5, so the addition is 9 actually. So this is how you like use a NumPy sum function. One thing to note here is that you can actually assess the individual elements in the NumPy using the basic index operation, like that is starting from the index 0. So let's say I have the D matrix and I want to assess the let's say this element 4. So what I will do is I will just go and write print the D matrix, and for me it's in row number 1 and column number 2. And if I print this, I will get the output as it's column number 1 actually. If I print this, I will get the output as 4. This is how you actually assess the elements in the NumPy 1D matrix. For 1D matrix, it remains the same. Like, you can just use, like, if you take the example of A. So if I print in A of 2, it should give me the result 5, which is expected output. So this is how you actually like assess the individual elements in the NumPy 1D or 2D array. I hope this is clear to you now and you have enjoyed the NumPy tutorial. We will see some of the more NumPy functions in the next tutorial. Till then, stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Thank you.